Ryan here in the picture had a very particular task to accomplish. Over here you can see a mother dairy sign. This particular mother dairy signboard is in the shape of a rhombus, and the side of the rhombus has been given to us as 12 centimeters. Now Ryan had to do two things. Firstly, he had to make 10 more signboards like this. So in order to make these signboards, Ryan had to know the amount of paint he would need. Further, Ryan also had to tape the sides of the particular signs. So in order to know how much tape he needed, he had to know the perimeter. And in order to know how much paint he needed, he had to know the area. So it has been given to us that this is a rhombus. So let us see how we can calculate the perimeter of a rhombus and how we can calculate the area of the rhombus. So firstly, we proceed with the calculation of perimeter of a rhombus. Now, just like it is true for any quadrilateral, it is also true for a rhombus that the perimeter is nothing but the sum of all four sides. And since it is a rhombus, all the four sides are equal. So we can write that the perimeter is 4 into the side, that is 12. This can also be written as 12 plus 12 plus 12 plus 12. But we are not writing that because, as you can see, it is quite tedious to write so many numbers. Instead, I simply write 4 into 12 because all sides are equal. And this gives me 48 centimeters. So the perimeter of the rhombus is 48 centimeters. And this has been calculated using the very simple formula, 4 into 12 centimeters. Next, we have to find out the area of the particular rhombus. Now, how can we find out the area? The formula for finding out the area of the rhombus is very simple. If you recall, for a parallelogram, the formula was base into height. Now, in the case of a rhombus, all sides are equal. So, this is 12 centimeters, and even this side will be 12 centimeters. So, if I consider this as the base and this as the height, even in the case of a rhombus, this formula can be applied. But in this case, we do not write base into height because all sides are equal. So the formula will be side, any side of the rhombus into height that is given to us. So the side given to us is 12 centimeters and the height given to us is 10 centimeters. So this gives us an area of 120 centimeters square. Now, over here, we have been supplied with the side as well as the height. Now, what do you think would have been the scenario if we did not have this information? That is, if we did not have this particular side or this particular height, how then would Ryan have calculated the particular area of the rhombus and how would he have made 10 more such signboards? Do you think it is a difficult task? That if height or side of the board is not given, but only the diagonals, that is, only these two lengths are given. Under such a circumstance, do you think it is difficult to calculate the area of the rhombus? The answer is no. It is very simple. So let us find out how we can do so. Now we have studied that the diagonals of a rhombus intersect each other at right angles and also they bisect one another. Now, using this particular property, we can find out the area of the rhombus if we have been given the length of the diagonals. So, over here, we consider a rhombus which has two diagonals. This is the rhombus that we have considered, A, B, C, D. Now, as you can see, we are considering one diagonal AC first. So, if we consider this diagonal, and since diagonals of a rhombus intersect each other at right angles, and also bisect each other, since a rhombus is a special case of a parallelogram, this diagonal will also bisect the entire rhombus into two parts. So what can I write? I can write the area of the rhombus as twice into triangle ABC. That is the area of triangle ABC. Likewise, I could have also written that the area of the rhombus is twice into area of triangle ACD. So either way we can proceed. Now let us see how we can calculate the area of triangle ABC. The area of triangle ABC can be easily calculated by writing half into base, that is AC into height. So first I write the height, that is OB, into the base, that is CA. So this gives me the area of the triangle ABC. Now if you look closely, you will find that I can move this to and rearrange the equation to write half into AC into 2OB. I have simply moved this to in front of OB and rearranged the equation. So this is what I get. Now look at the statement again closely. The diagonals of a rhombus bisect each other. So over here, AC and BD are bisecting each other. So what can I say? OB is equal to OD because it has been bisected by AC. So when I'm writing twice OB, I can replace it as half into AC into twice of OB will give me OB plus OD, which is nothing but BD. So I get half into AC into BD. AC is one of the diagonals and BD is the other diagonal. So the area of a rhombus is nothing but half into its product of diagonals. So it doesn't matter to us if we haven't been given the side of a particular rhombus or its height. If we have been simply given the length of both the diagonals, we can easily calculate the area as half into its product of diagonals.